A router is one of the most distinctive concepts that makes a framework a framework. So in this video, we'll talk about the Redwood router, how it differs from some of the other frameworks that are out there, and we'll put the pages, layouts, and components that we generated in the last video to good use, sewing everything together. If you're new to the Self Teach Me channel, my name is Amy Dutton. I'm a web designer and developer, and I want to help you level up and get you to where you want to be. So if this sounds interesting to you, hit the subscribe button below. Now, before we get into it, I did want to point out that I've created chapter marks and timestamps within the description. Feel free to jump around to the spot in the video that you're looking for. We'll start with our Redwood project. And if you want to follow along, I've created a link in the description below for the GitHub repo. You can go to the page, grab the link, and clone the repo to your computer, navigate to the current lesson that you're looking for, run yarn install and yarn redwood dev. And of course, if you don't want to mess with any of that, you can just open the project directly within Gitpod. Okay, once everything is set up, let's run yarn redwood dev within the terminal. Now our project should be available on localhost 8910. Now, if we look at this within the browser, one of the reasons that we're still getting the splash page is because we haven't listed a home page or the slash route. So let's jump over to VS Code and let's take a look inside of our router. And that's inside websourceroutes.tsx. And let's come on down. I'm going to change our feed page here to use the path slash. Now, if we go back to the browser and we're still on that slash route, you can see this automatically refreshed. You'll see our feed page component and not our Redwood splash page. Perfect. So let's go back to our router and let's talk about a few things here. You can see that we have our route component here, and that's being imported from Redwood. And this takes a path or the URL. We also have a page prop, and this is where we're passing in the page component that we want our route to use. Now notice we didn't have to import that anywhere. Our routes file is automatically aware of all the page components. Then the last prop that we're passing in is our name component. And this is how we'll refer to the page anytime we link between pages. Now, let me show you. Let's go into our pages folder and I'm going to pull up my feed page component. Now, I'm already importing a link here and you can see that's coming from our Redwood router package. And right now, this is linking to the feed page because it's saying routes.feed and it's getting that name feed from our name here. Now, let's change it so it's linking to an individual link page named link. So if I come back here, I can change this from routes.feed to routes.link. Let's change the text inside to say individual link. So I'm going to save this. If we go back to the browser, you should be able to see this in action. So now we have the text individual link, and clicking on the individual link text will take us to the link page. Now here's the beauty in the system. Let's go back to VS Code inside of our routes.tsx file, and let's change the URL for this individual link page. Say I want the URL to be shared-link instead of just the link. Now, if I hit save and I go back to the browser, it's going to give me an error because this URL no longer exists. But if I hit the back button and we click on this individual link, now remember, I didn't change the href here. But if I click on this, it now is taking me to the shared-link. The URL itself is different. Other frameworks may use a file or a folder-based routing system. So you'd have to move files and folders around to accommodate this change. And in some cases, when you move the folder, the paths within the files would also have to change, breaking the page. So I do like this system and that you have more control and more flexibility. So while we're here, let's make a few more changes to our routes. So for our individual link page, I just want the URL here to be slash and then the ID for whatever that particular link is. So this is going to be a dynamic route. I don't actually know what that ID is going to be. So here I'm going to change that shared link to be curly brackets ID. And we can also make this type safe by saying colon string. So now any URL is going to expect a string and not a number. Now let's test this out in the browser. Okay, I didn't even have to do anything and this is already failing. Actually, this was a plan fail. So if you look at the error here, it's saying that it's missing the parameter ID for our route. So that's saying now that we have specified that our route has to have an ID, it doesn't know what that actually is in the URL. So let's actually pull up our link page component. If we go back to VS Code and look inside of our link page folder, here we have our link page component. And inside with this boilerplate code, it includes a link to this particular route that we're trying to load. But this route now requires a parameter. So the easiest thing to do is just to delete this code and this page will now load. But this time, let me use this as an opportunity to show you how you can fix the link. So this link path is correct since we're using a named route, but we need to pass in a parameter that contains the ID of the link that we're trying to pass in. And we can do that by just passing in an object with all of the parameters that we'll need for our route. So in this case, we can say ID equals, say, Amy. So if I give this a save, now if we come back to the browser, you'll see that our page is back up and working. And if I click on this link, you can see that it's going to go to slash Amy. And we could change this to be slash Henry or slash Redwood. It doesn't really matter because it's dynamic. It's able to take in whatever we throw at it. Now we just need a way to take in this parameter into this page. And this actually just gets passed in like a prop. So if we come back over to VS Code, we have our link page component. Let's pass in an ID, and then you can reference it on the page just like you would a normal prop. So I'm going to put ID inside of curly brackets. And now if I give this a save, come back over to Chrome, you can see it says link page Redwood.js or link page Amy. Pretty cool, right? Now let's go back to our router, and I want to point out just one more thing. Here on our routes.tsx file, we're referencing our parameter that we're passing in as ID. But if I were to change this to slug and hit save, go back to Chrome, we're going to have a broken page again. We would have to come back here and update all of these references of ID to slug in order for the page to work again. So you can see that those variable names all need to match. And I'm going to hit undo so that we are using ID. I'm going to show you a bug that we've introduced. So let's go to our submit link. I'm going to come back over to Chrome here. And let's go to slash submit dash link. And when we hit enter, you'll notice this is pulling up our link page and we're passing in a ID of submit link. That's strange. It should have picked up our submit link page component. So why didn't this work? So what happened here? How do we get this to actually display our submit link page? Well, if we go back to our routes file, the way this works is our code will start at the top and then it will go down one by one until it will find the route that matches. So in this case, a slash submit link, this will fit in this case. It is almost like an ID that we're trying to pass in. So it will go ahead and exit before it even gets to this other route component. So in order for our submit link and actually our latest and our homepage to work, we need to move this down to the bottom. Now, if we go back over to the browser, you can see our submit link page. So let's make a few more changes. So I'm going to come back over to our router, and for our submit link page here, instead of this being submit dash link, let's just simplify this to be submit. So you'll notice that the routes that Redwood created by default line up with the actual component names, but they don't have to. We can change that. So for example, for our profile here, I want this to be slash profile slash whatever the nickname is for the user that we want to see their profile. I'm calling this parameter nickname because it's going to get a little confusing if we were just to call this username. A user is still going to sign in with their email address, but I want them to have a vanity URL. I also want to have a similar structure for our comments page here. So this will be profile slash nickname, which will be a string, slash comments. Then I'm going to do the same thing here for favorites. So you'll be able to see a user's favorites. And then for our edit page up here, I want to do something similar. So we'll say profile slash whatever the user's nickname is. And then let's just say edit. Sweet. So now that we have our routes set up, let's take a look at layouts. So we have a few different layouts that we have already stubbed out in the last video. So we have our base layout, our legal layout, our link layout, and our profile layout. And we want to apply these layouts to our routes. So within our router here, we can use a set and pass in a wrap prop to apply the correct layout. So here for our profile routes, I want to use our profile layout. And then we'll end our set on the other side of our route components. So you can see here that set is not defined. So I'm going to add that to our list of imports that's coming from our Redwood router. Now you'll notice that it can't find our profile layout here. If we hit Command period to pull up our quick fix menu, we can select this first one to add the import from our layout's profile layout. Okay, perfect. Now let's apply another layout. So I'm just going to copy this and we have our legal layout. So let's change this to be legal layout. And this is going to wrap our privacy disclaimers and terms. And we'll also want to make sure that we are importing our legal layout component at the top of our file. Then the last one that we have is our link layout. And we will wrap our set around all of our pages that are going to use our link layout. Now our base layout will be applied to all of our pages. So this will include our header and navigation, but it will wrap all the pages and all the sets, creating a nested structure. So one thing that we can do is we can just duplicate this line. We can say base layout, and then at the bottom of our file, let's go ahead and close out our set. Give that a save, and I believe, yep, we'll need to import our base layout. Give that a save. Now, before we pull this up within the browser, I'm going to pull up our base layout component here. And I'm just gonna add some text so that you can see this is our base layout. And then let's open up our link layout here. I'm gonna do something similar. Just gonna add some text here to say this is our link layout. I'm gonna give this a save. And now when we come back over to the browser, you can see that it's automatically loading our base layout, our link layout, and then we have our link page component. If we go over to one of our legal pages, and you can see our base layout and our privacy page, if we were to add some additional text here, just like we did for our link layout and our base layout, so you can say legal page, come over to the browser, you can see that it is also loading our legal page layout. Awesome, so this is looking great. Well, maybe not great, but our structure is there. But there's one last feature that I wanna show you. So our legal pages really aren't going to change once we add the initial copy. So one thing that we can do is we can come back over to our router here, and where we have our legal pages, I'm gonna hit Command Alt down arrow to insert multiple cursors here. And we can add a pre-render attribute to each of these route components. So if you're familiar with the various render modes, what this does is this will allow these pages to render the code at build time. Awesome. So as a quick recap, in this video, we took a detailed look at the router file, customizing some of our routes, wrapping them with layouts, and pre-rendering our legal pages. In the next video, we'll install Tailwind and set up our custom fonts and colors. And I think you'll be pleasantly surprised by how quick and easy this is within Redwood. If you like this video and want to see more videos on web design and development, or continue to follow along in this series, be sure to hit the subscribe button below. Hit the bell icon to receive notifications when new videos are posted. I'll catch you in the next one.